Welcome to a new reaction video. My name is Larissa and today I'm going to react to the new episode from Vikings, which is episode 4 from season 6. The last time we saw an episode and it was, yeah, remarkable. Well, that one thing happened with Oleg. He gave his brother a new piercing, but it was quite disturbing. Like, he was like, okay, he thinks he's a wolf or something like that, or a lion, but he's just a dog. And then he decided to actually put him in a kennel and give him like a ring through his mouth. That was really disturbing. You even saw Ivor looking like, holy shit. Also, that boy laughing so hard about that was also a bit troubling, but yeah, that was kind of the thing that I mostly reminded from the episode. Oh, there's my cat. I haven't seen him all day, so he wants a hug now. Come here, come on. He just walked away like I didn't exist. Anyway, and the last thing we saw was, well, we also saw that Lagertha like dug up her sword again, because she is going to fight again because she wants to protect those women who were attacked by the outlaws, who weren't killed by Bjorn. He sent them out there and now they're attacking those women. And Lagertha is going to like protect them, I think. And at the end we saw Bjorn's plan fail. He was coming for King Harald, but then, yeah, he ended up in a trap and there was fire everywhere. And it just, yeah, it didn't succeed like he wanted to. It didn't succeed at all. So, yeah, in this new episode we're probably going to see how this all continues. And I'm excited about that because I'm already loving this season and already so much crazy shit is happening, so let's go. Oh, and before I start, I want to wish you all a Merry Christmas, because the next reaction that's coming online is a Westworld reaction, but I recorded them in the summer, so that's coming online on like Christmas Eve. But you know, because I recorded that in the summer, I can't say Merry Christmas there, so I'm saying it in this video. Merry Christmas, everyone, and now we're going to watch Vikings together. He became quite good friends with Igor.
Super rapid, sweet.
We can talk.
Yes, we can talk.
This is probably the first time we actually saw him talk.
And everything in the whole of Rus, it's all yours.
You make me laugh. I know it really belongs to Oleg.
He doesn't know that.
Can talk. I can explain how you've been betrayed.
Oh my god, he doesn't even know that. That was something I honestly was already wondering about, because Oleg wants the power, but when that boy would, well, grow older, he's not just gonna give everything to Oleg. So, did he tell him? Didn't he? Does he even know? But apparently he didn't.
Some of you were shield men. Probably we fought together before the Wars of Paris, if you can still remember.
Of course, Lagertha.
Ah, be on eyesight. Please, come and sit down. Last night, I had a dream, and in that dream, I was sitting in a room with King Harald Finehair and King Bjorn Einsight.
Why do you not simply renounce this kingdom and go home with your warriors?
If nothing is real, we must still act as if it was. That now, both of you are my prisoners.
What?
It is through Bjorn Einsight, you still have an army, but your army, I believe, is not strong enough now to defeat me.
So,
how to resolve our differences?
There's not really a reason for him to do it, just
I'm tired of this old
to look powerful.
Thing. We will remain surrounded, but I will arrange to have food brought to you.
Oh, so in that way he's his prisoner. They surrounded him. I thought he was gonna throw him in a dungeon too. I don't like that man, but I already knew something was up with him when we saw him last season.
You mustn't be afraid for two reasons. Son and daughter of great warriors.
I'm not afraid. If they attack, I want to make my mother and father proud of
me.
I am proud of you.
And you.
So cute. Like these really tiny Vikings. What is he doing there now?
Out! I want to give you some responsibility. I don't think our family has ever truly recognized your talents.
Really?
Yes, you know very well. I hope you agree to this, Vincent. I'm trying to help you.
No,
I think he needs to get sober first.
I'll get better.
I won't disappoint you.
Oh.
time for you to tell me what really happened in Iceland between Floki and the settlers.
Oh shit.
I want the whole story, the truth. After all, I am a Viking. It was a matter of honor. But still, I can't just accept that Floki walked away. Surely someone killed him and hid the body. I had nothing to do with Floki's disappearance. You better pray to the gods that one day Floki returns to verify your story. Because up until that day, you, a man capable of slaughtering an entire family, will to me forever stand accused of his murder.
Come on, you knew they weren't just going to believe this.
Each must die someday. Even you, Bjorn Ironsight. Let me out!
Did they lock him up there so he can't drink again? Oh shit. Or was that his own wish so he could get better?
Where's Vincent?
Did he really think he'd recover this
soon? Go fight him.
I don't know how much time was between this and the conversation between them, but.
You will have to leave without him.
Don't be too hard on him.
I really want him to get better. I can't stand to watch this.
I love you, brother.
Don't you?
I always have and I always will. You have just betrayed me for the second time in your life. Good night.
Stand up!
I'm sorry. I don't want to see you anymore. And I have nothing more to say to you.
Ever like going to fully recover from this?
Is it true? Do I really own all the land and all the sky?
Yes, it all belongs to you.
Prince Oleg is asking for you.
So did he just tell Oleg that he told him? Or? Well, probably not.
No one can question your legitimacy to rule when I place you upon the throne.
So then I will be a puppet ruler.
Don't mess with me, Harvey the Bonus. You will be the king. You will be famous. Isn't that what you Vikings like?
You forget something. I'm a god. Descendant of Odin.
And you're not a god. You're not a god. I've had this wife. There's no saying she was a whore. That should be enough for you. But don't ever betray me. I'll stuff your bonus body in the casket with my wife.
Right. Yeah, that dude also has some serious issues. But I don't think Ivar is like gonna be okay with everything he says now. Now he knows that's how he really thinks.
Don't take everything too seriously, Ivar. Heroes are very passionate, very emotional. We get carried away sometimes, you understand? You are descended from wood. And of course, it makes me jealous.
Sure, man.
And it makes me love you.
Ivar's like, what am I supposed to do with this? In the beginning of the season, I was like, okay, this friendship between Oleg and Ivar is really nice. But now he's more friends with Igor, and Oleg, well, we already knew he was kind of crazy, but we keep finding out more.
It is time to elect and anoint a king for all Norway. A king who can unite the people. And what better man than you? Your Ironsight. Eldest son of the great Ragnar Lothbrok. What better king to command our poor, war-torn, fractured country?
So that's what he wants?
Of course, the city of Erdind. Oh, so much depends on it.
Are those the bandits again? Yeah, yep. There are so many. But these aren't just the men Bjorn, like, let go. Outcasted. I mean, there weren't that many, right? Maybe they just, like, they come from different parts and they, like, made a group together. Oh, even the older children are helping. Kill everyone, they don't even care. Yeah, he better doesn't die. These dudes are such cowards to like keep attacking a village with obviously outnumbered and are just all weak old people and children. She's back, bitch. If you just kill that asshole, because I really don't want to see his face again. Hey. That boy constantly wants to get weapons. No. What the hell? That little boy really didn't deserve that. He just wanted to be brave. Oh, I'm so sad about this. Where does she see that? Okay, remember last episode when I said maybe Bjorn should have never let them go? Because now they're just hurting innocent people. And now he killed Bjorn's son. I mean, just think about that. This show is messing with me again. Well, he was like the cutest kid ever, and I don't even like children, so that says a lot.
Yeah. Someday you might get free again.
I want to be free. Do you mean it?
I would just like the chance to overthrow Prince Oleg.
Okay, that was expectable, what to be it? Honest. Since Oleg...
I had to drink.
Acted
and then my dream
like that.
Village. I think it might have been Lagatha's village.
Lagatha's? You mean it was attacked? My children are there.
I'm sure it is not Lagatha's village.
Oh, I can't. If she finds out that it's her son,
believe me, I would like
who
to
died. Oh.
You mourn our dead.
and honor them, but we the living must try and ensure that their deaths were not in vain. We can abandon our village and the dead. We can abandon our grain and our livestock, and we can go and hide in the fields and hope the bandits don't find us. Or we can stay. We can prepare again to fight and defend what is ours.
I don't want to leave my mother.
You can all go if you want, but I will stay and defend the dead.
We will all stay.
None of us is afraid. Harry wasn't afraid. We should all stay and fight.
He died for all of us. So all of us will stay here, even if we have to die for them.
To Halenos. Tell them I love them.
Of course they will.
I'm already so sad for her. She doesn't even know it yet.
We're not told. Kings on the earth together here. To elect Bjorn Ironside, king of all Norway.
They're gonna do it.
I already have!
Right. Oh, okay. Yeah. I don't know what to think of this episode. Like, it was really good, but I'm so sad about what happened to Holly. Also, Holly is Bjorn's eldest son. And I mean, Bjorn and Torvi don't know it yet, but this is so messed up. Maybe I'm taking this too heavy, because with Vikings, it's like when they die in battle and then they go to Valhalla and the gods are with them and stuff like that. So it's not, that isn't as bad for them as it is for us. That's kind of the feeling I always get, because they believe in all those things after. But he was so young. He was just a kid. That's just not okay, you know? Yeah, I'm just, that scene just made me really, really sad. Like, we only know him since the beginning of this season. Well, of course, we know Bjorn had children. They never really showed them a lot before, and I believe this season those are new actors who are playing his children. So this was like the first season we actually got to see them talk and kind of got to meet them, like actual persons and not babies who are crying. And then in the fourth episode we lose Holly, and that's so sad because he was such a cute boy, and every time those children were on screen I was like, oh, they're so cute, those tiny Vikings. And yeah, now one of them is dead. If I think about it, we could have seen it coming that something was going to happen to him, because in the last episode he took that knife and that already kind of meant something and was already leading up to something. And then in this episode, first when he ran away and you were already like, oh, okay, I hope nothing's gonna happen to him. And then eventually it does. So there was some building up towards it. Also with the goodbye from Torvi and Ube and all that stuff. So if you're going to think in the TV show way about it, there was building up to it, so it didn't completely come out of nowhere, but it was still really a shock because I didn't think about it or anything. It's just really sad. For the rest of the episode, Fitzurk is really not doing well, holy shit. I feel really bad for Fitzurk, and I know he's trying, but that he just can't do it. But I don't know, I get Ube and I get that he's mad, and I really hope Fitzurk will get better someday, because like I already said, this trauma is just, yeah, too much for him, I think. I mean, this affected him so badly, and yeah, I just hope he'll get better someday, because it also hurts me to see him like that. I mean, we all know Fitzurk as that one brother who like never really was something. I mean, you have Bjorn, he's the eldest son of Ragnar Lodbrok, and you have Ube, who's like the eldest son of the children of Aslaug and Ragnar, so he's also kind of the eldest. And then there's Ivar, who like made himself a king slash god. And then there's like Fitzurk, you know, just Fitzurk. And we had Sigurd once, but he died a long time ago. But yeah, Fitzurk, he was just always that guy who was also there, and he just, yeah, he wasn't like really hungry for power like some of them, and he just wanted to live his life, you know? And these really bad events happened to him also because he jumped ship back then and went with Ivar. Of course, he couldn't have known what he knows now. Otherwise, I don't think he would have done it. But yeah, it's going really bad with him. And I feel bad for him. So I hope he'll get better someday. And then we have Ivar, who now wants to overthrow Oleg. Which I already saw kind of coming at the moment. He was like yelling at him and saying those things. And he's blaming it on being a widow and that he's having a hard time dealing with the death of his wife, even though he killed her himself. It's kind of a fake story, but yeah. Ivar knows at this moment that he shouldn't take too much of his bullshit, and I think he's doing, well, the right thing. I think he's making a smart choice trying to side with his brother, and that he told Igor about that he's the real heir, kind of. The real ruler. And I really like the friendship between Ivar and Igor. So we'll have to see where that's going with the other brother and yeah, if he's really going to free him and how that will end up. Yeah, I hope I kind of explained everything right because again, I'm so tired. Every Friday I have to wake up at 6 a.m. because school starts really early and I always record this on Friday. So then I'm home and I'm like, holy shit, I'm so tired, but I have to record Vikings. Not that I mind, but I'm really tired. Anyway, yeah, I'm just really sad about the whole Holly thing. He was such a cute boy and yeah, I'm just going to be so heartbroken when Torvi finds out or Bjorn. Oh, yeah, just, yeah. I'm trying to prepare myself for that already, but I know I'm just going to cry. I already cried so hard when that just happened, so yeah. Yeah. So yeah, then I hope you like this reaction. Again, Merry Christmas, and if you like this, leave a like, subscribe, and then I hope to see you at the next reaction. Bye!